Hello guys, welcome to Python for Data Analysis. In this section, we'll be talking about one of the most powerful tools in Python, which is for loops. For loops allow us to iterate over a sequence of elements and executing block of code for each of the elements. So make it to do repetition and repetition all over again in Python. Before we start coding, you know what to do. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. Let's code.
9 to 5 data.
Let's start by looking at a simple example of iterating over a list using a for loop. So let's say, for example, we have a list of fruits. Let's say fruits. Plus two. We have apple. And we have banana. And let's say we have cherry. If we want to print each of these items in the fruit list, so what we can do is use a for loop, and for that we'll just write a simple code and saying for fruits in fruits. So what do we want to do? We want to print the fruit. So running this code prints each of the item in the fruits list, which is apple, banana, cherry. So don't get confused. You know, we said for fruit in fruits. The code is actually written in this way to make it readable and explainable. So for example, the fruit can be anything. The fruit is the variable. And if you notice that the last word in front of in is the fruits, that is the main variable we're talking about. So the fruit is just to tell us each element we have in the variable. So for example, we can say for x in fruits. So the first item, that is the one we are trying to print out in each of these variable, can be any name. It can be x, it can be y, it can be z, but the main variable does not change. So for readability or for writing explainable code, that's why we say for fruit. So if we say for x in fruits and say print x, so we still get the same thing as above. You can see we have apple, banana, cherry. So what x is telling us is that we should go into this our fruit list and print each of the item. So we say, okay, print apple, print banana, print cherry. So we have iterate over the fruit list. So another use of for loop is that sometimes we want to execute a block of code for a specific number of times. That is, we want a code to keep running for a specific number of time. In this situation, then we have a function called range that will help us to achieve this. So to use range is just the way we have used the previous code. We just do for I in range, and we'll specify the number of times we want the code to be executed. So for example, if we do range and we put 5, so that means we have 5 iterable elements. We want 5 iterable elements, and you have to remember that Python is a zero index language. If we run this and we'll say for I in range 5, and we'll say print I. So if we run this now, we should know that what we get will be from 0 to 4. And that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So those are 5 elements. So when we do for I in range 5, it will print from 0 to 4. So put in mind that it will not print 5 as the last element. So because Python is a zero index based language. And using this range again, we can also specify where we want our counting or our element to start from. And also we can give a step. For example, if you say for I in range. So let's say we want to start our counting from 4 and we want it to stop at 15. So if we want it to stop at 15, that means we are going to put 16 as the last number and column and say print I. So if we run this, we can see it's starting from 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So that is the second way of using range. And another way of using range is that we can give a step. So for example, we say for I in range, let's say 4, and we want it to stop at 16. If I want it to stop at 16, that means I'm giving 17 as the last element. And the next thing again is that I can give a step. So let's say I want it to skip or go by 2 step, and I say 2. So that means I'm having something like 4, 6, 8, and so on and so forth until it gets to the last number I specified here. So if I do that and say print I, and I run this, so you can see that is 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, and 16. So it can't go beyond 16 again, because the last element we can reach here is 16. So if you had put this, even if you had put this at 18, it won't be able to go beyond 18, because, you know, like I said, it's a zero index based language. So if you put this at 18, so that means the last element that is supposed to print here is 17. But since we have put our step at 2, it will skip 17 and try to go to the next number after 17. So let's try something and see if what I'm saying is correct. So for I in range 4, comma, I put 18 because I want to stop at 17 and do step 2. So let's say print I. So you see we still get the same value as what we have above. So just like I've explained, 17 should have been the last element here, but because we have put step and we say okay, we are going by 2 step, so it will skip 17 and try to go to the next number after 17, which is 18. But on our code, we only specify the stopping number as 18, and automatically it's going to stop at 17 based on the fact that Python is a zero based language. So for loop can also be nested inside each other, allowing us to iterate over multiple sequences simultaneously. So let's take an example of that. Let's say, for example, I have a code that stores adjective. Let me say adj equals list of adjective, and that's red, big, and tasty. So I also have another list storing fruits, say our usual fruits, apple, banana, and cherry. So if I run all this, now I have our adjective and also we have fruits. So we can iterate through the adjective and also through the fruits and print a combination of the adjective and the fruits. Let's say, for example, I want to print something like red apple, big banana, tasty cherry, and, you know, do something like red banana, big apple, tasty cherry. So that can be done using for loops. So for example, what I'll do is say for a in adjective. So once I go through this adjective, I also want to go through each of the fruits, and let's say for fruits in fruits. So what I want is print a and also print f, sorry, fruits. So the way this loop works is that for the first element of this, it iterates all over the fruit. So for example, we are going through the red, and after we go through the red, we go through the fruit. So we get something like red apple, red banana, red cherry, and we all go again and we have something like big apple, big banana, big cherry, and we go again and have tasty apple, tasty banana, tasty cherry. So that is the way it works. So let's run it at and see what we have. So we have red apple, red banana, red cherry, big apple, big banana, big cherry. So we have tasty apple, tasty banana, tasty cherry. So That is the way a nested loops work. So, and that is it. We have covered the fundamentals of loops in Python. So in the next lesson, we are going to take another example of while loop, which is another version of loops in Python. Don't forget to put your question in the comment box, like the video, and subscribe to the channel. Happy coding.